kids are losing their childhoods because their parents are extremely overprotective. They're bubble-wrapped kids.
They never stop watching, even though playtime is limited to this tiny back deck.
Can we go into the grass?
No, you can play whatever you want on this deck.
Yeah, no, we can't.
And we're back. I'm Anthony Fury. We've got ourselves a real situation, folks. There is danger on the streets of Vaughan, Ontario. Get this, there are trees outside of a school with acorns on them, and the acorns might be endangering our kids.
So y'all need to hide your kids, hide your wife.
Big problems obviously require big government solutions. Thankfully, parent Donna Guestizia is on top of this. She appeared before the city of Vaughan to ask them to cut down the acorn trees next to St. Stephen's Catholic Elementary School because, as she says, the mere sight of acorns could cause anxiety in kids with nut allergies and bullies. Bullies may torment the allergic children with these acorns. There are many terms that we can use to describe this new level of stupidity. I'm going to file it in with the downfall of Western civilization. Now, I don't think anyone is going to be surprised at this, least of all our next guest, Lenore Skenazy. After all, she wrote the book on it, Free Range Kids, How to Raise Safe, Self-Reliant Children Without Going Nuts with Worry. She's also the host of Bubble Wrap Kids that you saw in an excerpt. She joins me now from New York. Lenore, thanks so much for being here. I want to ask you, on a scale of, say, 1 to 10, just how crazy, how nuts is this acorn
so
story?
So to speak. It's pinging. It's pinging at around 10.5 at this point because, of course, if the mother is very scared about these couple of trees around the school, what about all the other trees in Canada? Do they all have to be cut down? Should we do away with nut trees because they might cause anxiety in her child? Obviously, I think that this is not the way to go about raising a self-reliant child if you're so worried about not only the allergy, but the fear of the acorn. I always believe that since we cannot prepare the path for our children, we cannot get rid of every obstacle in their way, what we have to do is prepare our children for the path and get them to the point where they recognize, oh, I can't eat that, or oh, that person's mean, I'm going to avoid him. Rather than trying to solve every problem, including, do you know what she was actually worried about with the acorns? Did you read? It's not just that the acorns exist. The acorns themselves, even if an allergic kid or her allergic kid touched them, what I read was that you would actually have to get a squirrel, basically, crack open the nut and then shove that nut down her child's throat, which a bully in theory could do. For this to pose a true threat to her child. So she's really going several steps beyond even allergy to worry about bullying plus allergy, that nexus there, that might be the problem.
Lenore, things have changed so much even since I was a kid, and I'm not that mm-hmm. old. I mean, what? Where
How old
did
are
this?
You?
Where did this happen? Where did this segue in which we started bubble wrapping everyone come from?
Well, I am older probably than you, and I watched it come in. It came in when, I hate to blame the very medium that we're on right now, but when TV discovered that the ultimate story that would keep viewers glued to the screen any time of day and night, 24/7, was an abducted child, that became the go-to story for anyone at any time. And if there wasn't an abduction today, it would be an anniversary of one, or a watch out for one, or Halloween is coming, don't let your children get abducted. And then gradually, the idea of worrying about our kids became a big market even beyond abduction to, is your crib going to kill your child? Is your child going to choke on a hot dog? Is there something dangerous in your child's toy box? Find out more tonight at 11.
But the media did not drive, I understand that the media did drive some previous stories, but we definitely mm-hmm. didn't drive the acorn story. So is it now just permeated into parental psychology?
Yes. What parental psychology has sort of incorporated what I consider worst first thinking. In any situation, whether it's, I just read today that Girl Scouts who are going on a camp out here in my country, America, they're no longer allowed to toast their marshmallows. The s'mores, those delicious mushy cookies, have to
that's
be made
crazy.
With marshmallow.
That's crazy. That's like getting rid of childhood.
That's the hallmark. It is, but that's what I'm saying. So if you think of the worst possible thing first. Children could be hurt. Children could go up in flames. Children could choke. Children could get an allergic reaction because some bully has taken the time to take an acorn out of its shell and shove it directly down my child's throat. When you think of the worst thing first, then you start becoming completely irrational because something terrible could always be happening. In America recently, there was a horrible tragedy. There was a nanny who stabbed two children to death here in my city, New York. And afterwards, there were article after article, how to prevent your nanny from doing this, as if one incident once somewhere equals danger to all children at all time everywhere. That's become the way we think, that we parents are sort of trained to think. So I don't actually blame us parents, because we're told, worry about this. Here's an article on how to save your child from a terrible day outside. Here's 17 things you have to worry about on Halloween. Thanksgiving is coming up. Is your child allergic? Everything is put in terms of danger to children. That's sort of our scrim that we see the whole world through now, is danger and safety. And when you're looking for, is this safe? You're always going to find some tiny little thing that in some weird situation probably isn't safe. And that's how we think. Nothing
now, Lenore,
is safe enough.
We've got time just for one mm-hmm. more question. I imagine that continually trying to rescue kids inadvertently mm-hmm. ends up harming them. Tell me what you found.
Well, it's obvious as what you said. When we're always rushing in to tell kids you're not safe unless you're there with mommy, I'll save you, I'll protect you, the kid gets a couple of messages. One is that it's very dangerous out there. They can't trust anyone. They certainly can't trust another adult. They're helpless in a situation. So they lose their own self-confidence, and they also don't start believing anymore in the community that they're in. If everything and everyone is out to get them, the only safe place is back home with the doors locked. And we worry about kids getting fat and diabetes and depressed. That's what happens when kids aren't interacting with the world. But we are the ones saying it's too dangerous to go out there. I think it's too dangerous to stay inside.
Lenore, thanks so much for joining us.
Sure. Thank you, Anthony.
Folks, you can catch Lenore Scanese on Bubble Wrap Kids. And don't bubble wrap your children. It only hurts them in the end. Send me your thoughts on this. Anthony.Fury@sunmedia.ca.